Hallo und weiter geht's mit den Abenteuern von Captain Toffy Ganznuss. Dieses Mal in der Ursa Major Galaxie. Ist das jetzt eine Galaxie? In der große Bären Galaxie. The home sector of the Ursans. It remains mostly uncharted by Galaxy Force. It'll be a tough task to bear. Bear? No, it's bear. Okay, also wir haben natürlich hier Toffy Ganznuss, könnten wir natürlich wieder nehmen. Anna Berliache. Oh, die hat aber 5 Punkte. Er hat auch 5 Punkte. Auf 3 aufgeteilt. Der sieht aus wie Captain Kirk. Wir nehmen wieder Toffy Ganznuss, okay. Toffy. Hoffentlich kriegen wir diesmal einen Roboter. Gottes Willen. Wir haben hier einen. Das würde uns natürlich Wissenschaftsurteil geben hier, wenn wir den hier nehmen würden. The Fixer. Ich mag die ja optisch hier. Fräulein Rottenberger oder Rottenmeier oder wie hieß sie bei Heidi? Und Ted Barnett. Da würden wir wenigstens einen Attack kriegen. Das könnten wir eigentlich gut gebrauchen und hätten immerhin Science 3. Aber wenn wir jetzt sie nehmen, dann kriegen wir einen Attack und ein Bravado. Die ist eigentlich sehr gut für Away-Missionen, glaube ich, weil sie hier drei verschiedene Skills hat. Ich glaube, wir nehmen sie. So, wie nennen wir sie jetzt? Fräulein Rottenmeier. EI oder EY? Hm. Okay, haben wir Dr. Douglas hier irgendwo? Scheinbar nicht. Kein Dr. Douglas. Carmina Marin. Lake Kubilius. Lake Kubilius. Und Emily Mind. Hm. Emily Mainz. 2 Bravado. Dann hätten wir Bravado auf 3. Das wäre schon mal gar nicht schlecht, oder? Wir könnten Taktik auf 4 kriegen. Diplomatie auf 4 kriegen. Das wäre natürlich auch mal cool zur Abwechslung. Okay. Nehmen wir den. Der sieht aus wie ein Dieter Bohlen. Da ist der Toffy Ganznuss, sein Kollege Dr. Douglas. Oder wir nehmen hier eine von den beiden Blondinen hier. Ja, zu wenig Attack. Also kann sein, dass Dr. Douglas hier leider nicht mitspielen darf, diese Runde. Ja, obwohl, da hätten wir 4 Bravado. Wäre auch nicht schlecht. Das ist eigentlich, ich glaube, mit Bravado kann man sehr viel lösen. Nehmen wir mal Dr. Douglas wieder. Dr. Douglas. Leider wieder kein Roboter hier.
Könnt ihr mich überhaupt hören? Ich weiß gar nicht, ob ihr mich hören könnt. Kann sein, dass ich die ganze Zeit jetzt hier wieder leise geredet habe. Mal schauen. Vielleicht muss ich später nochmal was ändern hier. Ist ja nicht viel passiert. Wir haben uns nur die Crew ausgesucht. Okay, da ist das Ziel. Da haben wir, ach du meine Güte. Und wir haben wieder 8 Credits. Also 20 Crews eigentlich reicht. Teilen wir das mal hier zwischen auf. Und hoffen dann, dass alles in Ordnung geht hier. Guti. Da wissen wir nicht, was passiert. Da wissen wir nicht, was passiert, und da kriegen wir Fuel. Gehen wir mal zu diesem Asteroidengürtel. You've reached the asteroid field known as Orion's Buckle. Today it appears dense with asteroids of all shapes and sizes. Crossing won't be easy. Anything could happen in there. Könnte ich jetzt blasten oder hitch a ride on an asteroid? Dadurch würden wir Hülle verlieren. Hier würden wir keine Ahnung was verlieren. Aber das ist Bravado oder Tactics ist, glaube ich, der Weg hier. So, Angriff, glaube ich, funktioniert nicht so gut. Ah, machen wir Bravado. Cool. With a wink, you instruct your crew to watch and learn as you deftly swerve past asteroids at breakneck speed. Your stunt officers thank you for saving both the ship and a ton of fuel in the process. Autopilot is a real energy hog. Okay. So, hier kriegen wir vielleicht Crew dazu. Hier kriegen wir Food. Food haben wir sehr gut gebraucht. Hier ist Auto Scanning Range. Fliegen wir mal hier, dann kriegen wir Food. Your robotic lab assistant has been dropping beakers and bottles all day. Eventually you discover its new hands were installed upside down by someone. Okay. The AI controlling the ship's food replicator has decided it's graduated from common food and is only willing to produce tiny portions of space gourmet meals from now on. But it's burger night and the crew really just wants their burgers. Könnte ich die Burger selber machen? Den Replikator verkaufen? Oder der Crew sagen hier Space Gourmet, super duper. Versuchen wir mal. Ja. Scheiße. 6 Crew verlassen mich. Toll. Super. Naja, brauchen wir auch weniger Essen, glaube ich. Gehen wir hier hin. Hungry and desperate, you hail a passing alien ship. The holocom flickers on. Grahaha. Food? Only prime pupils get a tasty treat in my class. If you wish to survive, listen to my lecture carefully, Captain. For it will all be on the test. Present a doctor's note. Pull the fire alarm. Fire fuel-coated spitball. Fire alarm. You've got plenty of experience dodging responsibility, but when it comes to evade an exam, only one solution will do. With a wink, you lunge for the fire alarm before instructor Baxter knows what's going on. Okay. You totally confuse him for a moment, then he realizes the blaring alarm is not coming from his ship and he laughs. Grahaha, I hope you ace swimming lessons, puny captain. He barks as your sprinklers flood the ship. Wissen wir nicht. Dann mal hier, das ist der grüne Nebel. Your co-pilot, Ensign Blath Brooks, forgot to disengage the parking brake when you left your last stop. Thanks to this error, your main thrusters are mangled mess. The indestructible 11 is forced to pull over and an imposing space corp appears on your view screen. Oh no, it's a Popo! Sergeant Desmond Popo, to be exact, he says, smiling politely and tipping his hat. Now, the reason I pulled you over, floor it, cooperate. Floyd. You haven't done anything wrong, dammit. You're afraid for no rational reason, and you instruct your navigation officers to scram maximum warp. See ya, Popo. You're trying so hard to speed away from Sergeant Popo that you crash right into a giant pickle floating through space. Several crew members are injured. Here comes Sergeant Popo, and you're in a real pickle. Was ist das hier eigentlich? Pesken Outpost. They're always looking for hull plating. Ja, haben wir nicht so viel von, ne? Crew an, high demand. Jetzt habe ich beides nicht. Toll. Your ship is infested with warp weasels! The departments are all arguing over who should take care of the problem. Once everyone has a say, you consider your options. Convince the tech team to handle it. Domesticate the warp weasels. Irgendwas muss ja mal klappen hier. Game. You rally about half of the weasels to your cause with an impassioned speech. Unfortunately, this starts a warp weasel civil war on your ship. Your side wins in the end and you hold a feast to celebrate. Okay. Ich habe jetzt einen warp weasel als Crew. Okay. Was ist das hier? Das sieht natürlich interessant aus hier, ne? You are forced to stop as a Tacotian cowboy herds a very large group of brightly colored vacuum-dwelling beefalo across a busy space lane. Your navigator says it's probably safest to just wait it out. You're forced to wait for nearly 3 days as the seemingly endless line of beefalo winds its way past the crossing at the space lane. Eventually, the last of the stragglers make their way across and the Tacotians tips his 10 gallons head your way. You've discovered a Pescan outpost here in the frontier. The fish people are allied with the galaxy force, so you're certain that they'd be willing to let you stay here for a while. You should rest. Okay. After sharing a few war stories, they ask if you're interested in any training. We could use combat training. Okay. Oh, while flying, you discover a superheated ball of liquid tree dolomite coalesced near a white dwarf star. This material has the unusual property of being both effective at reinforcing your armor and an efficient fuel. Fuel haben wir genug, slather it on. A scientist in the medical bay tests a new intelligence serum on his dog. The dog now walks on two legs, talks, and has become the most intelligent being on the ship. Some people even think the dog would make a better captain. Commission the dog a science officer? Use the serum on other pets? Put the dog down. Science officer is good. Unfortunately, while he's great at science, the dog was not neutered before his transformation took place. You are confronted with several sexual harassment complaints from crew members with fleas and violated legs. Sadly, while getting dressed today, you find a hole in your lucky underpants. You are called in to handle a crew drama. Apparently, Ted and Alexis have been fighting again. Dakota found out and made her move on Ted. Now Alexis is a mess and Ted has threatened your transporter's engineer, Skylar. Make a move on Skylar or comfort Alexis. She's too good for Ted. Alexis is too good for Ted. You knock on the door to Alexis' private quarters. Cool. Alexis lets you in. You try to convince her that when one door closes, another one opens, and that this could be a new beginning for her. She wipes her tears away and nods in agreement. You embrace. Cool. Someone's broadcasting a message here. Okay. Warning, not enough red shirts for a full away team. The Admiral hates you, asking for a quick favor. Can you retrieve the Jellyak Ambassador from Nerbus 4? Your ship is closest. He understands if you don't have time. Why wouldn't you have time? The planet is just right there. 5 von 8, also 3 fehlen. Aber ich habe ja bisher schon so oft irgendwie schlecht gewürfelt. Das kann ja eigentlich nur gut gehen jetzt. So, die hat der ist eigentlich Dieter Bohlen. Wir schicken Dieter Bohlen. The team is herded into a long custom line. When your team finally reaches the booth and shows their interstellar passports, a stern uniformed hippoclop blinks its eye at Dieter Bohlen and booms, "Anything to declare?" Ask what's illegal. The team can't properly answer the question unless they know what's declarable on this planet. They don't want to get into trouble after all. Gott, oh Gott, oh Gott, oh Gott, oh Gott. Stopp, stopp, stopp. Nein! Ah! Ah! The Hippoclop hands you a thick manual, then charges you $89.95 for it. Will that be cash or charge? Dieter Bohlen hands over crew as collateral. Crew? What? Crew null? Oh, guys, moving on. After customs, the team meets the Jellyak Ambassador. It's awkward. Jellyaks are liquid beings. The Ambassador is a jar of pink liquid with eyeballs floating in it. Creepy. Will you escort the jar to High Command or is it just too weird? Verify it's the Ambassador. Ambassador, Dieter Bohlen said? Yes, yes, said a voice echoing through the minds of the away team. I get awfully sick of these. Yes, I'm a liquid ambassador in the jar. Get over it. Shit. Freeze the ambassador. You won't be smuggling liquid if you freeze the liquid. You order Dieter Bohlen to set the phaser to chill out. The frozen ambassador will be able to pass right through customs. Es geht so in die Hose. You were right, the team can pass through customs with no problem. Unfortunately, when they froze Ambassador, they froze his eyes as well as his body, and he will now be blind. Your crew must stand trial before the Jellyx. At the shuttle, the team finds an armed guard of Hippoclops surrounding it. An audit of your customs paperwork finds that you failed to visit the space notary for the proper stamp. Your leave is denied. Proceed to customs immediately. Demand an appeal. Dieter Bohlen is quick to demand an appeal. The highest ranking Hippoclops sighs and escorts the away team to the appeals line, which is even longer than the customs line. The away team prepares for their customs appeal. Dieter Bohlen steps up to the podium in front of an appeals committee of three angry, angry hippos who will hear and rule on the appeal. Ist eigentlich scheißegal, was ich jetzt nehme, weil ich habe alles drei nicht mehr. Dieter Bohlen places a jar containing the ambassador atop the podium, waiting to hear how the liquid diplomat will address the situation. It's a specialty, after all. Okay. The ambassador begins his mind speech. He negotiates a deal with the appeals committee. They stamp your team through, and the Hippoclops get two of your team members to use in scientific studies. That's good. The team won its customs appeal, but now must obtain a specific sticker to be affixed to the shuttle, allowing departure from Nurbus 4 space. Enough, cries Ambassador telepathically. Invoke the trial by combat. Wait, what? Nobody expects a veggie. Showing real and substantial... Guck dir das an! Scheiße! Showing real and substantial maturity, Dieter Bohlen whispers to the team that their strategy is to give veggies to the Hippoclops. Okay, Dieter Bohlen. Dieter Bohlen reaches under the armor of one Hippoclop and yanks its underwear up hard. This only serves to make the Hippoclop fly into a blinding rage. Tja. Yanks its underwear up hard. This only serves to make the Hippoclop fly into blinding rage. Yeah. Finally, you deliver the Jellyx ambassador to the space station, where the admiral is there to greet you. He thanks you for your help and reminds you to be sure to fill out all your away mission reports. Dieter Bohlen does what they're supposed to do. They hate it, but they do it. Okay. When the liquid Jellyx emerges from the planet, she tells the tale of her baby. Several of them telepathically apply to join your crew. Approve the application. Sehr gut. Who cares if they got no arms or bodies? Their jars can be stored easily in a closet, and you just padded your crew numbers. Okay, also verloren haben wir noch nicht hier. Gut. 2, 1. Also das scheint ja die einfache Route zu sein hier. Apparently your parents sent you a care package full of home-baked goods before you left, but the delivery drone only managed to catch up to you just now. How thoughtful. Ooh, after a flash of purple light, your ship is in another dimension. A mechanical bear, wolf, and raptor float before you. Whoa, it's the Mechatars! According to legend, these guys defend the universe from untold terrors. Are you a swarm? They ask. No? The Mechatars are pleased to meet you and ask for your help in defeating the enemies of the Mechatars. Mechaverse. Mechaverse. The Swarm. Ja, jetzt zumindest eine Chance, dass ich hier. Ah! Okay. You tell the Mechatars to lead the way and follow them gallantly into battle. Unfortunately, for some reason, the Mechatar ships can only turn right while you are going in circles. You get swarmed and are forced to retreat. Okay, scheiße. Internal sensors detect an alien presence has suddenly appeared aboard your ship. The alien has given no indications of his intentions. Machen wir mal limit the alien's movements about the ship. Cool. Cornered in the kitchen, the alien converts nearby food stores into a mysterious goo, sprays a nearby crew member with it, and disappears. Later in the medbay, the sprayed crew member spontaneously replicates, adding to your crew size. Also minus 3 food plus 4 crew? Okay. Warum nicht? Ich brauche bald mal wieder food, glaube ich. Oculoid Federation Military Outposts. These guys love NutriPaste for some reason. The Oculoids, a race of squid eyeball creatures, have no beef with Galaxy Force, so you're welcome to stay for a while. You assigned Oculoid Escort leans in close and whispers that he's willing to do some trading off the books. Contraband, let's go! You arrive in a poorly lit room and several other off-duty oculoids are sitting around staring at you with more eyes than you can count. Your escort vouches for you and talks begin. So, also, nehmen wir mal hier Hülle, haben wir. Aber wir brauchen Food. Ha. Okay. Ach, mehr haben die nicht. Okay. Mal gucken, was sie hier kriegen könnten. The Oculoids look at one another with all of their eyes until one speaks up. We've got some intel we could probably part with. I've also got some stuff that isn't entirely safe or legal. One of the Oculoids steps forward. I've got this illegal phaser modification that's guaranteed to pack a punch. I also have an incredibly impactable pair of jagged metal dice. Phaser mods. Zu teuer. I think I'm all set. So, das ist SOS und wir kriegen Food. Das sieht gut aus. Several of your crew have become infected with tapeworm holes. They're very similar to terrestrial tapeworms, but they have the ability to create tiny wormholes to steal food and nutrients. The afflicted crew will starve without help. Galaxy Force has received a distress call from a crew filming a nature documentary, das hatten wir doch eben schon, on the third planet of the Akriti system. Hier ist auch ein Akriti system. They're trapped and you're the closest ship. Nee, das nicht nochmal. Moving on. Suddenly, the ship finds itself in a golden haze. What initially appears to be a solar flare is actually a swarm of millions of fireflies, which is remarkable because who ever heard of a firefly in space? Your crew discusses what to do. Feed the critters! Okay. You escape during the ensuing feeding frenzy and see that the cloud has expanded to twice its size. Who knew that feeding the fireflies makes them reproduce? The galaxy will want to know this interesting discovery. Okay. One of your scientists was experimenting with creating a singularity inside the lab. It was going great until the controlled singularity became uncontrolled. You either increase power to contain it or let it collapse on its own. Yeah. Toll. Out of fuel! A vessel from the humanoid Tarian group, the Wreck Anxile, hails you and says they have some fuel to spare. Or they're asking for the donation of blood. Alright, fine, blood for fuel. Shit. You receive a frantic message from the cafeteria. Apparently someone added water to the giant brick of dehydrated NutriPaste and it has begun to grow exponentially. Several crew members are trapped behind the giant blob of NutriPaste. Look up a solution fast. You learn that dousing the NutriPaste with fuel causes a molecular reaction which stalls its growth. You base it with fuel immediately, using 5-second rule, you just hose it off afterwards. NutriPaste for everybody. Cool. Traffic is backed up for several parsecs due to an overturned energy tanker that flipped due to loose wormhole cover. A robotic representation of Cosmic Craft Club received your distress call and has fuel for you. You thank the robot and remind yourself to renew your CCC membership later this light year. Engineering report: system around the ship either have too much power or not enough power. Sometimes both. It's getting a little ridiculous and your chief of engineering has run out of ideas, short of running a ship-wide diagnostic. Okay. Na klar. Engineers think they found the problem. One of the airlock doors is draining a lot of power. Once they cut the power, the force field the door was emitting to seal the breach vanishes and the entire deck decompresses explosively. Toffee Gansnuss, The Indestructible 11, not that indestructible. That's nice. Incredibly dead. Okay. Dieter Bohlen. Tot, 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 tot. Super. Okay, das versuchen wir vielleicht demnächst nochmal. Mal schauen. Bis denn.